Hello, I am Alisha Mallik. I have came to the screen of Shiro Vision with some new pieces of news for you. CBSE declares new scheme for the 2021-22 academic year divided into two. CBSE released a notification on Monday announcing a new scheme for 2021-22 wherein the academic year will be divided into two halves with approximately 50% syllabus in such term. The first term exam will be held in November. The decision was taken to increase probability of having a board-conducted exam for classes 10 and 12 at the end of the academic session. The points of note in CBSE special scheme for 2021-22. The syllabus for the academic session 2021-22 will be divided into two terms. The syllabus of our board exam 2022 will be rationalized. For academic transaction, however, CBSE schools will follow the curriculum and syllabus released by CBSE on March 31. Efforts will be made to make internal assessments or practicals or project work for more credible and valid. Details of CBSE curriculum transaction. For classes 9 and 10, internal assessment. For classes 11 and 12, internal assessment would include in topic or unit. School would create a student profile for all assessments. CBSE will facilitate school to upload marks of internal assessment. Guidelines for the internal assessment for all subjects will also be released along with the rationalized term-wise divided syllabus for the session 2021-22. Wimbledon 2021. Roger Federer becomes oldest man to reach quarters in Open era. Alexander Zverev stunned. The center court loved Roger Federer's show on the final manic Monday at Wimbledon. The 39-year-old put on a clinical performance to beat 23rd seed Lorenzo Sonego 75-64-62 and progress to his 18th quarter-final at the grass court Grand Slam. The 8-time champion became the youngest man in the Open era to reach the last 8 at Wimbledon. Federer needed to only 2 hours and 11 minutes at the center court to outclass 26-year-old Sonego, who went off the boil after posing a stiff fight in the opening set. There were glimpses of vintage Federer at Wimbledon as the 39-year-old was hitting those winners at play. Federer looked at complete control in the last two sets as he seemingly told the world he is not done yet. Federer will face the winner of the last 16 match between second seed Daniil Medvedev and 14th seed Hubert Hurkacz. Notably, their match on court 2 was suspended when Medvedev was trailing in the fourth set 6-2, 6-7, 3-6 and 3-4 due to rain. It will be completed on Tuesday. The Canadian, who came into the match with a 3-0 deficit against Zverev, finally managed to hold his nerve and script a 6-4, 7-6, 3-6, 3-6, 6-4 victory in a little over 4 hours. Israel sees drop in Pfizer vaccine protection against COVID infections. Israel reported on Monday a decrease in the effectiveness of the Pfizer-BioNTech COVID-19 vaccine in preventing infections and symptomatic illness, but said it remained highly effective in preventing serious illness. Vaccine effectiveness is preventing both infection and symptomatic disease failed to 64% since June 6. The health ministry said. At the same time, the vaccine was 93% effective in preventing hospitalization and serious illness from the coronavirus. A Pfizer spokesperson declined to comment on the data from Israel, but cited other research showing that antibodies elicited by the vaccine were still able to neutralize all tested variants, including Delta, albeit at reduced strength. About 60% of Israel, 9.3 million population, have received at least one shot of Pfizer's vaccine in a campaign that saw daily cases drop from more than 10,000 in January to single digits last month. This spurred Israel to drop nearly all social distancing as well as the requirement to wear masks, though the latter was partially reinforced in the recent days. At the same time, Delta, which has become a globally dominant variant of the coronavirus, began to spread. Data scientist Yoran Segal of Israel Weizmann Institute of Science said the country was unlikely to experience the high level of hospitalizations seen earlier in the year since there were much fewer critical ill. He said it was fine to continue with the life back to normal and without restrictions, while stepping up measures like vaccinations, outreach, and ensuring the testing for Israelis returning home from abroad. Rats empty 12 wine bottles in Tamil Nadu liquor store. Rats have emptied 12 wine bottles kept in a government-run TASMAC liquor outlet in a town near Gudalur in the Nilgiris district in Tamil Nadu. The incident came into light after TASMAC employees opened the shop at Kadampuza on Monday, which had been kept closed for a long time due to the lockdown. They found the caps of the 12 quarter liquor bottles open, with the bite marks of the rats and wine in them, the official sources said. On being informed, the supervisor and senior TASMAC officials carried out an investigation while revealed the presence of rats inside the shop. They said the cost of the bottles is said to be around ₹1,500, they said.
Zero Vision. Shabar Shati. সবার পাশে জিরো ভিশন। জিরো ভিশন আজ কলকাতা তথা গ্রাম বাংলার পশ্চিমবঙ্গের সাধারণ মানুষের পাশে এসে দাঁড়িয়েছে। জিরো ভিশন সবার সাথে সবার পাশে, আপনারাও পারেন জিরো ভিশনের মতন সবার পাশে এসে দাঁড়াতে। আসুন না, সাহায্যের হাত বাড়িয়ে দিই। আপনারা যদি সাহায্য করতে চান, তলার এই নাম্বারগুলোর সাথে যোগাযোগ করতে পারে। প্রত্যেকটাই আমাদের জিরো ভিশন সংস্থার নাম্বার। ভালো থাকুন, সুস্থ থাকুন।
That's it for today for me and my team. Thank you for watching. Please stay safe and stay at home. If you like our channel, please do subscribe, like, share and comment. Thank you.